Hugo Boss did not design any uniforms. Not for the SS, not for the SA, not for the Wehrmacht or the Hitler Youth, and neither for the 1936 Olympic team, which is sometimes here. Every so often, you hear that Hugo Boss, either the man or the company, had a huge and decisive impact upon the dress style and indeed the whole aesthetics of the National Socialist regime. It's often said that he was responsible for either the design of the Wehrmacht uniform and or the design of the famous black uniform of the General SS, as well as many other things. In fact, he has been credited at some point with the design of almost all uniforms, may it be party organizations or Wehrmacht or anything else of the time. Often, this belief is presented with a certain amount of admiration. The idea being that at least that's something you can say. Yes, it was without question a terrible regime, but it's acceptable to say that the uniforms look good because they were typical Hugo Boss design. This happened just recently when I was making a video for another channel. I was describing the black Panzerman's uniform, and it didn't take long before comments like classic Hugo Boss started to appear, without context. Because it wasn't presented as a fact that is interesting, but as an established fact that everybody would know already. It was presumed to be known and to be relatable. So there's the reason why this video is on our YouTube channel. There is a connection between tanks and Hugo Boss, and that is the black uniform of the tank man. Which brings me to the core of the statement, which is really important to me because so many people still cling to the myth that Hugo Boss did indeed design uniforms for the NS regime. Hugo Boss did not design any uniforms, not for the SS, not for the SA, not for the Wehrmacht or the Hitler Youth, and neither for the 1936 Olympic team, which is sometimes here. Yes, the Hugo Boss company grew during this time from a small local company to a large medium-sized firm, as a clothing factory and a uniform factory, later in time exclusively as a uniform factory. This factory or company served the needs of the Third Reich and benefited from this economically. Because during the Weimar Republic, making uniforms had been a niche market and it was difficult to make a living from it. However, this niche grew rapidly thanks to the so-called uniforming of society, and the Hugo Boss uniform factory profited from this immensely. It's only natural that when a society has a sudden and great need for something, it's the established producers who benefit first, if they make the right moves. And so within a few years, this small company, which was almost bankrupt at the beginning of 1930, became a strong medium-sized enterprise with 10 times the number of employees compared to 1929 and 30. A big advantage for Hugo Boss was that he was already known as a uniform manufacturer, as he had delivered uniforms to the NSDAP for a long time, most likely from 1928, but definitely from 1934. In 1938, the process had developed to such an extent that, quote, from 1938, the company converted solely to producing uniforms, not only for the Wehrmacht, but also for the NSDAP, the SA, and the SS, unquote. It's important to understand that in this market, Hugo Boss was only one important player and came nowhere close to being the market leader. It was only one of many companies and, quote, manufacturers were not involved in the development of the pattern for the uniforms, unquote. This means Hugo Boss wasn't either. On the contrary, quote, in the terms of uniform production, everything was specified from the materials to be used, the pattern, and often even the methods of production. There was little room for design creativity, unquote. Everything lay in the hand of institutions, for the NSDAP, for example, at the Reichszeugmeisterei, who, quote, awarded licenses to traders and factories, standardized designs, production methods, quality, and even published a color card for the fabrics, unquote. No fewer than 15,000 firms and 75,000 tailors received these designs and licenses, but the institutions determined the designs, and for the famous black SS uniform, we even know who that was. It's no secret that Karl Diebitsch and Walter Heck were responsible for the design and the process of the design. Karl Diebitsch had been a member of the NSDAP since 1920 and was in the SS from 1933 onwards. He was Himmler's so-called artistic advisor, and it was he who designed many of the central objects of the SS, thereby influencing the design aesthetics of the NS regime as a whole, the most famous of these objects being the color patches of the SS uniforms and the SS dagger. Together with the SS-man Walter Heck, who was a graphic designer, they designed the black SS uniform. And Hugo Boss never, at any time, had anything to do with the design. So if, for example, a Wiki article says that Hugo Boss produced uniforms, it means exactly that, the physical production. Aside from that, Hugo Boss did have, of course, many connections to National Socialism. He joined the party on April 1, 1931, and later became a patron member of the SS. In addition, the economic development of his company was closely linked to the development of the NS regime. During the war, he used forced labor in his factories, including 30 to 40 French prisoners of war and approximately 150 forced laborers of various nationalities, 75% of which were women. If you would like to find out more about the company up to the end of the war, then I can recommend this book by Roman Köster from 1999, Hugo Boss, 1924 to 1945, The History of a Clothing Factory Between the Weimar Republic and the Third Reich. And if you're more interested in the details regarding the aspect of forced labor, take a look at the study by Elizabeth Timm from 1999, Hugo Ferdinand Boss and the Hugo Boss Company, a documentation. So, let me think. Was that everything? Yes. The two books I recommended are also the foundation and basis of this video. I just thought it was important to clear up this misunderstanding. Hugo Boss never designed uniforms for the NS regime, nor did he influence the style. There is no such thing as a classic Hugo Boss design for the SS or for the Wehrmacht. Thank you for watching and goodbye.